¿Tú me oyes?
¿Hago el sonido bien? ¡Ay, Dios mío!
We're trying to help a small group of patients with a very devastating condition known as neurofibromatosis type 2.
These individuals, usually at a young age, develop multiple tumors in and around their brain and spine that cause hearing and imbalance.
For many deaf patients, we can use a device called a cochlear implant, but these patients with NF2 don't have a functioning hearing nerve anymore.
Mrs. Bowden, she'd seen many local neurosurgeons in the community. She has quite a complex history of having multiple surgeries in the past. She had some hearing. We knew that jumping into surgery was not the right move for her, and so we actually waited as a team, and then it didn't take long for her hearing really to start to weaken.
Actual implant itself, it has two parts. It has a part that kind of sits kind of on top of the ear or behind the ear here and has wires that travel through the ear and then land on the brainstem. Once we have that in, then I have my team of audiologists and electrophysiologists that then stimulate each electrode one by one to see which ones would work, which ones are stimulating hearing, and we do that by monitoring brain waves.
The external part takes sound, converts it into electrical information and transmits it across the skin.
It's trying to do what the auditory nerve, the cochlear nerve, is supposed to do.
This is a multidisciplinary procedure, so there's many people involved, like neurosurgeons, neurotologists, audiologists, electrophysiologists, as well as, you know, the entire OR staff.
It's a very complicated process of trying to match her own physiology to the mechanical aspects of the device.
You could just see her face and the emotion that she felt when she was able to, you know, hear something for the first time.
¿Qué oyes?
Los sonidos.
¿Qué oyes los sonidos?
She was just so grateful for the ability to hear again.
Every single time you get a good result with this, it is remarkable.
Every week, we all meet, we discuss 10 specialists under one roof that intersect over the disease of a given patient. This is personalized medicine at its best.